Welcome students. Today we'll be learning the quantitative techniques and research. I'll take you through the course outline as we try to find out what will you learn through the course. My name is Mr. Benson. And I hope you go very well as you learn this unit. Now the first topic that we learn is the foundations of research. Now, what are the foundations or what are the reasons that people decided that students must actually learn this under customer service? Now, under the foundations of research, we'll talk about what is the meaning of research, what is the quality of research that is required for you to be able to actually understand that the foundations of research has the main thing that will be discussed. Now, another thing that we'll actually talk about is the problem identifications and formulation. Anytime that you are actually doing research, it is important to know that anytime you're doing research, you must identify a problem. That is, research actually, for you to be able to do research, you are required to first identify a problem that exists, in the society. And then after you've identified the problem, you must formulate it. You must find the ways to actually go in-depth analysis. You must have an analysis of whatever the problem is. And when you are able to do that, you formulate now a hypothesis or a, what you usually call hypothesis formulation. For example, you may want to do a research to realize that why students maybe in public school passed more than students in private school. So that in that situation, that's the problem that you want to do. And then you must do an in-depth, when you realize your problem, you must do an in-depth analysis where you come up with hypotheses. Now, a hypothesis in this case is a statement where you say what you think your data will give you. For example, you can come up and say, the reason that students in private schools were better than students in public schools. You may give some of the reasons that maybe make that decision. And in that case, that will be a hypothesis. And then there's something called the research design. The research design is also referred to as the research methodology. In this case, you want to talk about the methods that you want to use to decimate the problem at hand. Now, the research design, in this case, you may say that you use different tools and different methods that you use. For example, you may decide under the methodology that the method that we use to collect data will be maybe using questionnaires, you may use samples, etc. Then let's come and look at qualitative and quantitative research. Okay? Quantitative and qualitative research. Now, this the research where you do and you want to find out what is the quality of whatever you are actually doing. What is the quality of the research? For example, I want to do a research. Let's just use the previous example on why students in private schools perform better in KCPE than the students in public schools. When I'm doing a qualitative research, I may come up and say that maybe the students in the private schools are receiving better quality. They are receiving more time with the trainer, more time with the trainers. And in that case, when they have more time as well, we will come and discuss and call it the quantitative part of it. For example, you may come and say maybe the students in a private institutions are able to attend preps, are able to have more quantity with their, more time with their trainers. And in this case, the quantity research will actually look at, you can come and say the effect of time on the performance of students in the KCPE. Then the fifth topic that we'll talk about is sampling. Now sampling is a rather wide thing because sampling, for example, sampling is usually used when you have a large population. When you're having a large population, it is not possible for someone to just come and decide to carry out a census. For example, I may tell you to go and do a research of the number of indigenous trees. in Mount Kenya, Mount Kenya Forest. Okay? This could be the research that you're supposed to carry out. Now, Mount Kenya Forest is maybe more than 10 kilometers square. You cannot go and do an actual population count of all the trees. In this case, if this is the whole, if this is the whole forest, you can decide to pick a small sample of maybe 100 meters square. 100 meters square. And this now sample will represent the whole population of this. Therefore, you're saying a sample is used when you have a large population and you just take a small sample of that population. Now, we have different methods that are used in sampling. You usually have the stratified sampling. We have random sampling. Both these are methods of sampling. Stratified is when you pick actual stratas, okay? Random is you come and decide, I look for this spot, and another spot, and another spot. That's what you mean by a random sampling method. Then you go to what you actually refer to as data collection. In data collection, data collections are the methods that will actually be used to obtain data in the field. You may decide to obtain data in the field by using methods such as direct observation. Okay? Direct observation. Direct observation. In this case, what you mean by that is that if you have been told to go and look for the indigenous trees in the forest, you actually go to the forest yourself and look for that actual data. Then you can also decide to use another method of data collection. You can decide to use questionnaires. Now, this is in a situation where you're trying to look at the quality of things. You may actually give questionnaires to your respondents and they give you answers to you. Another method that is used for data collection, you can actually think of instead of using a questionnaire, you actually go and do interviews. And this is all part of research. Then data analysis. After you've been able to collect your data, you must analyze it. You must find ways to know what that data say. And in the data analysis, you're just trying to find what is the data telling us? What does the data say? Okay, what is the data telling us? For example, after you've collected some information about the indigenous trees, okay, you may want to analyze that data. How you come and decide that the indigenous trees we have, maybe four types, you may be having something like the Nandi flame. You come and say you have another indigenous tree. And then this data, when you come and analyze it, now it will allow you to come up with a form of presentation. So when you are still learning data analysis, we also talk about data presentation. How do you present data? Data presentation. How do you present data? So for example, you may come up with and say that you may use something usually called tabulation or graph work, where you come and draw a graph, different bar graphs, to show you, maybe you can come and say the number of trees that were Nandi flames were this, the number of trees that were indigenous were this, and so on and so forth. So data presentation usually looks at the tabulation and the actual trees that were actually there. Then we'll talk about report writing. Now this is actually a very important point in the report writing, because after you've really collected all this data, you want yourself to be able to report that data. You must write a report or a project in this case. We find that for most of you, when you get to your third module, you'll have to write a project, a trade project. And in this class, we'll talk about how do you write reports. How do you write a report? For example, you've done a whole interview and you want to write a report about it. How do you do it? So all that we learn under the report writing, the styles that are used in writing a report, the tense that is used when doing a report, and finally, not finally, but rather, the ninth topic will be the business plan. Now most, like I usually tell most of my students, not everyone will come and get employed. And for that reason, I usually prefer all students know how to write a business plan, okay? A business plan will actually tell you what, if for example you decided that school is done and you don't want to get employed or you want to do something as you look for employment, you must know how to write a business plan, and I'll take you through the steps of writing a business plan in this case, the different chapters, the different topics, the marketing plan, the financial plan. We have something like the marketing plan, we have the financial plan, we also have something usually called the market analysis. How do you analyze the market? You cannot just go and open maybe a salon next to another salon. Don't go and open an M-Pesa next to another M-Pesa where people have actually, someone already controls, has a huge market share. And that's, you've seen some people do that and you wonder why their cereal shop is not picking up. It's because they didn't do something usually called market analysis. Finally, we'll talk about entrepreneurship. Well, require you to come up with actual ideas of businesses that can be done. That's all for today. I hope you get the chance to actually write the notes that have been posted, and we'll meet next time where now we'll be discussing these two topics under a video. The class will be learnt in three ways. We'll be having chats, so we'll be having three classes a week. The first class will be a class where we'll be having videos posted. Audios posted. We'll be having a chat in the portal, a chat in the e-learning portal. And also, the second class now will be having videos posted, audios, and notes writing. So in this case, we'll not be chatting, but we'll be having notes. And the third class will be now a Zoom class. Okay? This now will be a Zoom class where we discuss everything, all the notes that you've written under topic 1, 2, not topic but class 1, 2, and 3, we'll come and discuss those notes. That's how we learn this unit. Also, we'll have the assessment, we'll have a CAT, then a personal assignment. And then the end of semester exam. This will be 30 marks. I'll add these two and do, so whatever it will be, I'll add those two and find the average. And then I come and add it to the 70 marks of the end of semester. The personal assignment will actually try, I'll actually have you guys write a report. I'll give you a topic where you go and research on it and come up with a report from that research, okay? So this unit is actually done by students doing a diploma in customer service. That's all for today. Thank you and have a great weekend.